Hi children, how are you all? I think all of you are fine, doing well. Children, today we are going to learn a new chapter. Interesting, important and easy also. If you are going to face competitive examination in future, you will get questions from this chapter. And you are going to study this chapter in the next standard also. The chapter name is Arithmetic Progression. What do you mean by Arithmetic Progression? To understand this chapter Arithmetic Progression, we need to understand an important word, that is sequence. What is the meaning of the sequence? Let us understand by taking example from our day-to-day life. I think all of you have seen staircase. People used staircase to reach first floor, second floor. Yes? What is the interesting thing in this staircase? How this staircase and arithmetic progression is related, or how this staircase and sequence is related? Let us see. If I remove the plastering of the staircase, what do you observe? Exactly. We observe the bricks used to build the steps. If you observe the first step, you are observing the two bricks are used to build the first step. For the second step, four bricks. For the third step, 6 bricks. And for the fourth step, 8 bricks. If you observe carefully, you will identify that by increasing 2 bricks, the steps are built. Then, what is the number of bricks used to build the fifth step? Yes, you are exactly right. They use 10 bricks to build the fifth step. That means you are observing a pattern and you can guess what is the number of bricks used to build the next step. For the sixth step, yes, you are right, it is 12 bricks. Let us see the number pattern. For first step, they are using 2 bricks. For the second, 4. For the third step, 6. And for the fourth step, 8. And so on. For the fifth step, yes, you are right, it is 10 bricks. And what is the pattern you are observing? Increasing by 2. Yes, this is following some certain pattern or some rule. Is it not, children? Let us take one more example. I think all of you have played rubber ball. What happens if I throw a rubber ball? Exactly, it bounces. Yes, imagine that I am throwing a rubber ball. So it bounces. As it bounces and the height of the ball decreases. Yes? Imagine when initially I dropped that rubber ball. I am dropping that ball from 64 meter height. When it bounces for the first time and the height decreases such a way that the height of the ball is off of the initial height. For the next, it is off of the previous height. Then what is the height of this ball? It is off of the previous height. That is 8 meter. Off of 16 meter is 8 meter. What may be the height of the rubber ball for the next bounce? Exactly right. It is 4 meter. You can guess what is the next number in this pattern. This is because this also following certain pattern. Yes? Let us take one more example. We all play this card house games. So to build this card house, we use the cards. If you see the last step, how many cards are used in this step? 3 cards. Below that, 3 plus 3, 6 cards. Below that, it is 9 cards. Yes. So that means if we move towards down, the number of cards increasing is plus 3. Yes, it is increasing plus 3. Then what is the number of cards used below this third step, that is here? Yes, you are right. 9 plus 3, 12 cards. You can see that. 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. 9 plus 3, 12. What may be the number of cards in the last step? Yes, you are right. It is 12 plus 3, 15. Let us consider one more example. Here, Vihan is getting pocket money. I think you all get pocket money. Yes? So, Vihan gets his pocket money as rupees 500. And his pocket money also increases. every year he gets the double the previous year money. That means for the next year he is getting 1,000 rupees as his pocket money, because this year he is getting ₹500. For the next year it is double of it, that is ₹1,000. What may be the pocket money for the next year? Yes, it is ₹2,000. For the fourth year he is getting, yes, you are right, it is 4,000, because double of 2,000 is 4,000. What may be his pocket money for the next year? Yes, it is ₹8,000. How you can guess the number? Here also it is following certain rule or certain pattern. Yes, these type of number patterns are known as sequences, children. These are the four number patterns we have seen. Yes, it is following certain rule. This one is also following certain rule. This is also following certain rule, and this one also. So, a sequence is an arrangement of any objects or a set of numbers in a particular order followed by some rule. Here we won't consider any objects, here we consider only numbers. So, we can say a sequence is an arrangement of set of numbers in a particular order followed by some rules. And each number in the sequence is called term. Here 2 is a term of this sequence, 8 is the term of this sequence, 32 is the term of this sequence, and 9 is the term of this sequence. Is 8 is the term of this sequence? Yes, the next term is half of 16 is 8, hence 8 is the term of this sequence. Is 6 is the term of this sequence? No, 6 is not the term of this sequence, because half of 8 is 4. But here 6 is the term of this sequence. Yes, 5 is the term of this sequence? No, 5 is not the term of this sequence, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Yes, and the notation A1, A2, A3, etc. AN is used to denote the different terms in a sequence. Here the term 2 is called as the first term or the initial term of this sequence, and it is denoted by A1. And the next one is A2, and the next one is A3. If we know the last term, we represent that by AN. Yes, here also 3 is the first term, 6 is the second term, 9 is the third term, and so on. Yes, if we know the last term of the sequence, then we represent that by AN. And if you observe these, for example, to get the next number, we are adding plus 2. That means the number of bricks increased is plus 2 to build the next steps. And if you observe the pattern here the number 32 is half of 64. That means when the rubber ball bounces, the height of the ball is half of the initial height or the half of the previous height. And in the card house example, to build the below steps, the number of cards increased is 3. Yes, so 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 3 is 9, and in the fourth row we have 12 cards. Here every year Vihan's pocket money increases twice of the previous year. So that means to get the next number, we have to multiply the previous one by 2. If you observe here, in these two examples, we are adding a definite number to get the next number. These type of sequences are known as arithmetic sequences or arithmetic progressions. Let us learn in detail by taking some more examples. If you observe this sequence, yes, no doubt it is a sequence because it is set of natural number and every term increases by 1. If you add plus 1 to the 6, you will get the next term as 7. If you add plus 1 to the 7, you will get the next term 8. Here also it is increasing by 2. If you add plus 2 to the 1, you are getting the next number. If you add plus 2 to 3, you will get 5. If you add plus 2 to 5, you are getting the next term as 7. Yes, these are example for sequence as well as arithmetic progression. Let us See some more example. 4, 7, 10, 13. Yes, children, here the number we are adding is plus 3. Yes. If you add plus 3 to the first term, you are getting the second term. If you add plus 3 to the second term, you are getting the third term. That means to get the third term, we are adding the definite number 2 times. To get the fourth term, we are adding the definite number 3 times. That means if you see the place of the term, it is fourth place. We are adding the definite term 3 times to get the fourth term. Yes, here also 1, 4, 9, 16. Here 1 to 4, it is plus 3. 4 to 9, it is plus 5. 9 to 16, it is plus 7. But if you observe this example, here we are not adding a definite number. The number we are adding is increasing. If you observe the next example, 3 to 5, we are adding plus 2. 5 to 8, we are adding plus 3. To get 14, we are adding plus 6. Here also it is not following the pattern, that is adding a definite number. 8 to 5, here it is decreasing. That means we are subtracting 3 from 8, or we can also say this as we are adding minus 3. If you add minus 3 to 8, we get 5. If you add minus 3 to 5, you get 2. If you add minus 3 to 2, you are getting minus 1. If you add minus 3 to minus 1, you get minus 4. Yes, here if you observe this example, the terms are decreasing. Next, hey, this one is very interesting. Is this a sequence? Yes, definitely it is a sequence. And definitely it is an arithmetic sequence. Which is the definite number we are adding here? Yes, we are adding 0 to get the next term. If you add 0 to the first term, you are getting the next term. If you add 0 to the second term, you are getting the third term. Yes, this is also an example for arithmetic progression. If you observe here, minus 3 to 0. See, always the sequence may not start with positive number. It may also start with a negative number. So, minus 3 to 0, 0 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 9. So, what we have to see to tell that a sequence as an arithmetic sequence, the difference between the two successive numbers must be same. That means minus 3 and 0, the difference between these two is plus 3. To know the definite number added here, we have to subtract the previous number from the next term. That is, 0 is the second term. We have to subtract the first term from the second term. That is, 0 minus of minus 3 is plus 3. That means we are adding plus 3 to get the next number. Yes, minus 3 plus 3 is 0. 0 plus 3 is 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 3 is 9. Hence, this is also an example for arithmetic sequence. Except E and D, all other examples are example for arithmetic sequences. Then, what is an arithmetic sequence? Let us see. A sequence in which every term is created by adding or subtracting a definite number, this is important, to the preceding number is an arithmetic sequence. The first term of this sequence or the arithmetic progression, arithmetic sequence is also known as arithmetic progression, is called the initial term or the first term, and we know it denote this by the letter A or A1. A or A1 is the initial term. The value by which consecutive term increases or decreases is called the common difference. To find the common difference, what we do is we subtract the preceding term from the successive term. That means we subtract A1 from A2 or A2 from the next term, that is A3, or we subtract A4 from A5. To find the next term, what we do? We add the common difference to the previous term. For example, in case of the steps. First, we add 2 to get the next term. That is 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 2, 10. That is the number of bricks used to build the fifth step is 10 bricks. To know what is the number of bricks used to build the sixth step is 10 plus 2, that is 12. Yes. To know the next term, we add common difference to the previous term. And the general form of the AP will be like this. The first term is A. If you add common difference D to the first term, you get the second term. If you add the common difference to A plus D, you will get the third term, and so on. How to express this in general form? Here, if you add common difference n minus 1 time to the initial term, you will get the nth term. That means to get the 10th term, we have to add common difference 9 times to the first term. Observe here how many times we are adding D to get the 6th term. See, 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, 5 time. To get the 6th term, we are adding 1 time less to 6th term, that is 5. To get the 4th term, yes, 1 time less means 3 times, yes. One time we have added, one more time we have added, another time we have added. To get the A4, we are adding the D 3 times. Yes, D, D, D. Yes, so hence the general term of the AP is AN equals A plus 1 less than N times D is added to the initial term. And in some example, we see like this 1, 4, 7, 10, 13, where we can count the number of terms in the arithmetic progression or AP. AP is the short form of the arithmetic progression. Those type of progressions are called as finite arithmetic progression. Sometimes we see this dotted symbols. That means this sequence is not ending. We can't count the number of terms in the arithmetic progression. This progression has indefinite terms. These type of progressions are called as infinite arithmetic progression. Children, up to this you learnt what do you mean by sequences, terms of sequences, and the special type of sequence, that is arithmetic sequences, and the general form of the arithmetic sequences. Let us solve few questions on this. What is the next term of the arithmetic sequence? Find the common difference and add the common difference to 9 to get the next term. What is the next term of the arithmetic sequence? Minus 5, minus 1, 3, 7, 11. Here also same thing you have to do. What is the next term of the arithmetic sequence? 8, 5, 2, minus 1, minus 4. Here it is decreasing. Be careful. What is the next term of the arithmetic sequence? 0, 2, 4, 6, etc. Yes, a sequence may also start with 0. A sequence may also start with negative number. So, it may increase or it may decrease. But what we have to see here is we are adding definite number to get the next term. That is the condition for the arithmetic sequence. Yes. So, you answer all these questions, and I am giving practice questions for you in the textbook. So, if you see the chapter 1 arithmetic progression in mathematics part 1 book in page number 7, you will come across this exercise 1.1. You please solve these two mains, that is first main and second main, children. Okay, I think all of you are clear with the meaning of arithmetic progression and its general form. Okay, thank you. Stay home, stay safe. Learn from where you are. Thank you, children.